What we've created here at the University of Michigan is something we call Sirius. Essentially, what is a replica of Siri, as well as Microsoft Cortana and Google's Google Now, what we call intelligent personal assistants. In a lot of ways, what we've created here with Sirius is like what Linux is to Windows, right? So with Windows, when you have a computer and you have Windows on it, we traditionally don't have access, and we currently don't have access to change Windows into being whatever we want it to be. With Linux, you have your own open source operating system that you can customize to be whatever you want. And so what we try to do with Sirius is to provide an open source common infrastructure that anyone can customize and deploy and have freedom to do whatever they'd like, but have a starting point that is as intelligent as what you would find in these proprietary environments. One thing that we've done with this is we've created an intelligent personal assistant that you can ask questions to, things that you would expect Wikipedia to know.
When was this built?
Another use case could potentially be a startup who would like to provide new types of services that look like an intelligent personal assistant.
There are several components for the system. One component is the speech recognition component, which basically translates natural speech into text. The next step is to actually interpret the text, extract the semantics meaning of the text, so we could actually conduct a search in the Wikipedia database and extract answers from Wikipedia.
There's one significant way that we're different in terms of features is to provide this image capability where we can use images as well as our speech to interact with it. And that pushes the state of the art. So if you have a smartphone or if you have image capturing wearable on, you can simply capture the image of something you're looking at in your environment and ask a question about it. Now we can build much faster than could be done when it's only industry companies that are contributing to it. All of the universities of the world, all of the startups of the world can contribute to this open platform, and we have the resource of all of their ideas that can come together and come into this one central infrastructure. So in many ways, we may be able to do more impressive and amazing things than we've seen from the companies themselves who's had a monopoly on this infrastructure.
Some people ask whether speech or visual-driven set of queries or interaction with the computer, whether it's just a hype or it's going to be the next big thing and people really going to adopt this. But I truly believe that that's going to be the natural trend, because if you think about computing, first we had a keyboard, right? We didn't even have a mouse before. And that was very not natural in terms of how you actually communicate. I think in the future we will actually communicate with computers more like we communicate with humans, that you could just ask maybe ambiguous question and the computer is going to be able to interpret what you're really asking and try to actually ask back. And I think Siri has really helped us to actually really look at this question as, you know, how do we really actually interact with computers? How do we actually make a more natural way of doing this? I think that's definitely the future that we're going towards.
Cubic centimeter scale has been reported. We're looking at cubic millimeter scale, which is 10 cubed, or 1,000 times smaller than that.